So your Mac comes with 46 different apps pre-installed. Let's run them all down in one take in only 3 minutes. Here we go. So Safari is the web browser, and for some people the only app they need. Then you've got Mail, which allows you to hook into corporate and standard email systems like Gmail and iCloud. You've got Contacts, which allows you to share phone numbers, email addresses across all your iCloud devices. And Calendar allows you to share events complete with alarms and alerts and things like that. Reminders allows you to also do alerts and alarms. And also do things like to-do lists. Notes is kind of a free-form information sharing app that allows you to just type text, do checklists, all sorts of things. Then you've got Preview, which allows you to open up PDFs, images, and other types of files to view them and annotate them. You've got Maps that can help you locate something and also get directions. Messages allows you to send messages between Apple devices and also over SMS if you have an iPhone. FaceTime is a video chat app. QuickTime allows you to open and play video files and do some basic editing. Photos allows you to manage your photo library and share photos. iMovie is a pretty powerful video editor. Pages, pretty powerful word processor. Numbers, a very powerful spreadsheet program. And Keynote, a great presentation app. iTunes allows you to organize all of your media, including music, but also allows you to access Apple Music, rent videos, and do a bunch of other things. iBooks allows you to buy books from Apple, but also you can store your own ebooks and read them there. You've got the App Store allows you to buy new apps. Photobooth is something that allows you to use your camera to take quick photos from your Mac. You've got Dictionary to look up words and use different dictionaries that you can download. Calculator allows you to do simple and complex calculations. GarageBand is a great music creation tool. Activity Monitor is a utility app for if you're having trouble with your Mac, you want to troubleshoot things. Airport Utility allows you to configure your Airport Extreme or Time Capsule. Audio MIDI Setup is for if you have a MIDI keyboard and you need to configure it. Automator allows you to create little programs to do repetitive tasks on your Mac. Bootcamp Assistant allows you to install Windows on a partition on your Mac. Bluetooth Files Exchange is an old app that allows you to send files to Bluetooth devices. Chess is a multiplayer or single player chess game. ColorSync Utility is something for graphics professionals to calibrate your screen. Console is another system app for troubleshooting issues. Digital Color Meter allows you to see the color underneath the pointer on your screen. Disk Utility allows you to configure and initialize hard drives. DVD Player allows you to play video DVDs that are connected to your Mac. Fontbook, you can install and manage the fonts you have. Grapher allows you to do 2 and 3D graphs of math equations. Image capture, you can access scanners and cameras. Keychain access, you can see the certificates and passwords stored on your Mac. Migration assistant, you can pull a user account from another Mac. It's great when you're setting up a Mac the first time. Script editor, another way to automate tasks. Stickies creates these little sticky notes that can appear on your desktop. System information, you can view all sorts of information about your hardware. Terminal, you can access command line stuff. And TextEdit is a great little word processor. It's very cross-platform compatible. You can do simple little small word processing docs. And VoiceOver Utility is an accessibility feature for people with vision impairments so it can read things that are on the screen.